Hi, this is Dion. I get a message from somebody who have a problem with starting problems. This is BMW, and he like to know how to reach his battery and do some simple checkings about his starting problem. Now, first of all, you need a simple voltmeter. Now you put him on 20. Yeah, just okay. Open the seat and take off this. Yep. And watch it how I take the thing out. The same way I take it out, you have to replace it back. Otherwise, you will have a nasty job. First of all, you pull it right this way. So. Then I need my both hands, so turn. So there's the battery. Okay, I'm right back. So I just adjust the voltmeter on it. Here, this is the minus and this is the plus, and you can see I have a very healthy 12.4. I use this to protect the coat, the paint coat. Now this battery will do. I just drive about a week or more not, so most of the time the power will be a little bit higher than this. Now let's keep. You can see it, the volt is 13.8. This is great. I can see the battery is fine and the generator will be loading the battery. This will be functioning, quite important. Does not change much when I put the lights on like this. It just dropped a little bit. I really can see the generator is running fine. My battery is fine also. So I do not have a problem with this bike. But what's the point? You have to check the connections. When you see some dirt on the connector, the cables here and there, when you start take it off, first you remove the minus and then the plus. Use some sandpaper and put some Vaseline on to grease it, so it will avoid to have any dirt on the connectors. And first thing you're gonna do is follow the minus cable. You go over here, there. Oops. Here. He makes a connection. Yeah, you can take this loose and check it if you have any dirt on this one. It must be fine. Another point is when you bike. If you really don't run at all, you can always check. All lights are burning. Is it in neutral? And etc. etc. You always need a little bit of shock. Even now, it's very warm. You still need it a little bit, but you can take it back very soon. Okay. Now you can always. You can always put one of the sparks out and put it somewhere in metal from the bike and try to start. And you can, if you see some sparking is on it, you can see your injection, your ignition system is okay. you can put the sparks back. This bike will be react nasty when the sparks are off. So by any doubt, replace them. They don't do not cost very much. Second, you can check the connections. If there is anything wrong about this one. Okay, and otherwise you can do is check your fuses on the other side of the bike for the fuse of the first and the sixth fuse can be be important things like the fuel pump, the injection system, and the computer under this you can check. Okay. Well, what about the condition of the battery? When you put the connections on the and you see it voltage like this, you know you are your battery is empty or most of the time completely wasted. I put it now firm back on and I get enough voltage on the cable. Another trick I always do, if the battery is fine enough, I put put the strong circuit on and turn on the lights. When it drop very hard, more than 0.5, I know the battery is in very bad shape. This is an easy thing to do. My bike run about a week because of the weather and my health. So the battery is not very high loaded. But this bike, most of the time, if you're not a leak problem of electricity, you can, 3, 4, 5 weeks without any charging, they still can be started. The battery is quite big. I know some small Japanese cars who have the same size of battery. Okay. This is the Motronic, the system of the injection system. When you doubt, you can always put this plug off and check the connection if there are any dirt on it. Just a little bit dirt will interrupt the working of the injection system. I think it's all not a bad idea when you have some problems. To check it, you can use Vaseline just a little bit to protect the connections of it. This is the cable of the fuel pump. It's always a good idea to check this one also. You can see if you mount it back on the right place. The right way. Okay, here are the fuses. You can see on the box on outside where they're from. I always check this one from the fuel pump, and when I put one out, I check if there is any dirt on it. Now, this one is fine. And you can see it here. Maybe you have to clean it. And I know sometimes when I put this block out, they're just very loose. You can check it yourself. Okay. So we have now checked the battery. The voltage of the battery. We're checking the loading of the generator or not. We're checking the cable of the fuel pump. We're checking the fuses. I tell you to check any cables or you see anything, the mass connector of the battery, and so etc. There are things you can easily check yourself. Then you can check the plugs, spark plugs. But when you still have problem and still found nothing, now then I think you need to find a technician with more equipment and knowledge, and then it will not be easy to find it just like this. But these are things you can do easy yourself. Thank you for watching and bye.